What's up, loves? It's Princy215. God and Gaia is so amazing, y'all. And I truly hope that you are living your best fucking life. And if you are not living your best fucking life, then you know that you need to contact Nutric Healing, okay? All my information will be below, by the way. So anyway, you guys, I really want to hop into this video. This video is episode 3. And we are going to be talking about overt narcissism, okay? We're going to talk about these overt narcissists, these overt matronites, okay? And remember, I made the term matronites, which are evil entities in this matrix that want to keep good loving people like us down, but they can't keep us down. That's why they're matronites. Anyway, so you guys, I'm going to let you guys know the difference between a overt narc who potentially could be your boss, your employer, your mom, your dad. You feel me? My first episodes were on malignant narcs. Malignant narcs are more dangerous. A malignant narc could potentially physically harm someone and even, you know, try to kill someone. But an overt narc has nothing on malignant narc. You feel me? But they're still very annoying. They are very annoying because overt narcs will seem to come off as alphas. And that's why I wanted to make this video, because I really want to put out here in this world, my voice matters. And people who are like me, who are searching this type of stuff and who are like me, I don't want you guys to ever feel gaslit. Just because someone is displaying aggression, and just because someone is freaking, because I got my notes right here. So when it comes to an overt narc who is a boss, they're not leaders. You feel me? An alpha is a leader. An alpha, where's my thing at? So when it comes to alphas, they are strong. They have a sense of self. Alphas are very resilient. Alphas, honestly, especially if you are a black sheep, alphas basically can get thrown to the wolves and come back and lead the pack. You feel me? That's what an alpha is. An alpha will lead. If you take away all the credentials, because let's be real, a lot of these overt narcissists who become bosses, they are only in those positions because of their credentials. If it wasn't for the degrees, if it wasn't for the licensures, they wouldn't be in those situations. They have to be able to control. In order for them to control, they need to have a tangible item to prove to their victims, I am more powerful than you. I know more than you. But if you take away all their credentials, they would just be a beta. They wouldn't know how to lead. They can't lead. And this is why they need the power. An overt narcissistic boss is always in the fear frequency. So they use their power to mask their fear, to make it seem like they are more powerful than you. They are over you. And yeah, they're very grandiose. Everything's about them. Like, and I'm gonna give y'all examples, of course, but, and they're very extroverted. That's the thing. Like, they will go to all the events, to all the board meetings. They will do everything to put their name out there. They will literally control the whole office, but they're predators. They will literally watch all those. If they run a business, right, they will pay attention to each of their employers and see who they can use, who they can suck, who they can antagonize. They are predators. That's what these bosses are. Being a boss and being an overt narc is kind of hand in hand. When you have a company that's ran by an alpha, that alpha is a leader. A leader never wants to dominate you. A leader will encourage you. An alpha is in desire to be in control of their own life. So if an alpha is in control of their own life, you don't think that they're going to help you be in control of your own life. An alpha does not want to control or antagonize anyone, right? And with this being said, alphas are very authentic. A narcissistic matronite, a narcissistic overt narc, is not authentic. They will literally work their way up by climbing on the backs of other people. And like y'all, and like I told y'all, I am a therapist. I am a master's level therapist. I come from the hood, so I have a very good experience with everything. You feel me? And I see firsthand how these overt narcs will get these businesses, will use, mental health is very important. I got into mental health because of my own story. I was my first case study. I healed myself. I became a better version of myself, 10 times better, 30, 100 times better than the person I used to be, but that person is still always with me. With that being said, you can't get into a field of mental health of people who actually need help and use them to build your own empire, to make your, certain field is not meant for that. If you want to have, if everything's about money, then you you need to go to business or, and not, again, not owning some type of mental health facility does not make you a leader. Is if you are a narcissist, you're just a boss, you're just demanding, you are just using your employees. And on top of that, again, it's our clients. Our clients are the ones who genuinely need help. And if you are in this business just so you can have safety, just so your family can have money and wealth, that's a lack mindset. That's a leader. An alpha is actually providing a service. If a leader and an alpha owns a business, they will not only make sure their employees are well respected, well taken care of, but the clients that they serve, the clients that they serve will be in good hands. Their mental health will be a priority. You cannot run an establishment and a business that has mental health issues and not even focus on that. It's all about the check. When I'm gonna get this insurance money. That's what y'all, I'm about to really fucking snap on this video, bro. Cause that's the shit that really pisses me off. Just because somebody goes to school and get fucking 4 or 5 degrees, that shit don't mean nothing if your heart not pure. Again, you can remove all the degrees and you, these, if we lived in a world where there was no papers, but yet it was word by mouth, this person did it. Cause trainings matter, don't get it fucked up. In order to be effective and to really help someone, you need to be trained by somebody who really cares, who really had, who's a master. But just because these people go to the master and get trained, don't mean that they are going to become a master. They then will take all this knowledge and become a predator. This is the type of world we live in. Just because you come sit in my classroom, don't mean that you're like me. And people will go through the system incognito. But the real ones will peep it, though. The real ones will peep that you're not real. So with that being said, degrees don't mean shit, y'all. It means something. Don't get it fucked up. It means something. Because we have to do this intensive training to help people. I spent 5 years in school. So trust me, that matters for me because my heart is pure. I needed that so I can help my people. And not only that, I help myself first. Education is beautiful. Don't get it twisted. However, these people will use education as a way to condemn and to use and manipulate people. And that's not right. Education is beautiful. Education, it should be a way for us to continue to train, know better techniques, learn, continue to grow. So we can help the world. That's our service. People want to infiltrate us so bad. That's the word I was looking for. It's called infiltration when you try to seep in and you're just disguised and you're just trying to assimilate and act like someone else. You're not us. That's the difference between light workers and dark workers, y'all. This is why I'm making this video. This video is about overt narcs who are in this field. Who are in, and I'm gonna just speak about my field. Fuck it, y'all. I'm gonna leave the other fields for other light workers who are in those fields. I'm a light worker. I am a therapist. I have been in a mental health field for years, and what I see is that people do not care about our children, about our adults, our elderly adults. It's all about the check. They are only in these situations just to receive a fucking check. I'ma always use myself as an example, y'all. I have I've had great supervisors. Do not get me wrong. I've had supervisors who are real alphas. I've had supervisors who are, see, and now I stopped using the term boss for real. I thought boss is good, but not in this damn age when you have overt narcissists who want special treatment, who feel like they are the prize and this is my establishment, this is mine. But what service are you providing to people? A real leader, a real alpha woman or man is providing a real service. That's what we are here to do, is to provide a service. A service, what is a service, y'all? When y'all go, let's be real, if you a girl, if you a female, y'all saying, what's up, mommy? If you going to go get your hair done, get your nails done, you want quality service, right? You want someone who's really going to take care of you, who's not going to burn you all up with the fucking flat iron and rip your hair out when they combing it, getting your nails done. You don't want somebody who's going to take that little machine and burning off your cuticles and fucking you up and hurting you. It's like, yo, I'm paying for a service. A service means a service is healing. A service is a form of healing. I'm serving you. I'm serving you food for your hunger. I'm serving you some water for your thirst. I'm serving you quality self-love care for your body, doing your nails, doing your hair. I'm serving you a mental health treatment to help you heal and become your highest self. Whatever your mental health treatment is, whether you need cognitive help with your thought patterns, rather you need cognitive help with rephrasing your traumas and looking at life differently, approaching your traumatic experiences differently, rather you need service with coming out of a toxic environment, I am here to serve you, to help you become your greatest self. And these narcs are not in it for that, y'all. This is why you have to stay woke. This is why. Just because a person has 5 degrees and licensures don't mean that they care about you or your fucking kids. Y'all just be giving them y'all money just because they have a license. That license don't mean nothing. I'm going to tell you why. Like I said, I had wonderful, amazing supervisors who looked me dead in my face and told me, I want you to be better than me. All this knowledge I have, I'm giving it to you. Go be better. Go make the world better. Shout out to, I'm not going to say her name for confidentiality purposes, but you know who you are. Shout out to you, my supervisor, who's a white woman. She was amazing to me. And not even just her, but she's the top one because of the fact of her being a white woman, because of her being 20 plus years older than me. And treating me as if, is she 20 years older than me? But whatever. Treating me like she got 20 plus years in this field, though. And guess what? She treated me like I was one of her own. I was her soul sister. She didn't treat me like she was above me. No, she taught me. And what is she? Double licensed. That's what I'm saying, y'all. License matters, but look at who got it. My white supervisor, who is an amazing woman to me, oh, she got all these licenses and degrees. She is so articulate. She is so phenomenal. And I'm black, I'm dark skinned. When she talks to me, she will literally, yo, I'm not even, okay. She's such a good person. Let me just get to the bad stuff, okay? This video is about these narcs, okay? Fuck these narcs. Let me tell y'all why. I had 2 other supervisors who were narcs, who had companies and all this stuff. And as a black American woman, y'all know my story. You can go to my page and y'all can see my story. I'm not ashamed of my story. I gotta talk about my story because being in college, I was in a homeless program for 5 years, which was called the Promise Program. It helped youth who had no family and no home. So my story's out here. I don't care. I'm not ashamed because look where I'm at now. So my supervisors know this stuff. My supervisors know that this is why I said they will watch you and see if you're weak. They will use you. Because I'm a light worker, because I'm an empath, because I love my clients with my whole heart, I'm a pawn. I mean, I'm an asset. They see me as an asset because, but in the same breath, they see me as a pawn. They will threaten me.
oh, you're replaceable, I can replace you, then replace me then. But yet they will try to keep me still in the same position because they don't want to see me grow and be better. And I'm gonna tell y'all why. I had two supervisors, one as an intern. While I was an intern, this woman was a narcissist. She was an overt narcissist. She had no integrity, no authenticity, no type of healing nature to her, no type of womanly nature. It was just all power, domination, and control. That's in the fear frequency. She was not an alpha. She was a beta. You get me? Get what I'm saying? People will give praise to people just because you scream and yell and you big bad wolf, that don't make you an alpha. Sorry. You're really a beta. You have a mask on. If you take away all your designer, if you take away your bags, all your money, if you come down, I bet you, your beta is going to show, because you won't have a pure, authentic, genuine way to connect with people heart to heart. I'm gonna give y'all a few examples before this video gets too long. Like I said, keep track. My internship supervisor, who was a narcissistic woman, before she even did anything to me, I was blinded by her. Why? Because we're dark skinned, because I'm like, she gang. But guess what? When you a Black American, it's a different drip. I'm not here to bash nobody from any other state. I mean, any other country. But being a Black American woman spiritual, being a Black American spiritual woman is a little different, because my supervisor, who was not even from America, who's from a whole different island, come here. I'm thinking we're a gang because of our skin complexion. That don't mean nothing. So I'm gonna give y'all two examples with her, and I'm gonna do more videos on this. This ain't over yet. We had one client who literally the client's mom even peeped something from her. And I'm sitting here defending her because she is my teacher. I'm thinking I gotta be like her because she got the money. She got that check. I'm like, period. I gotta get like her. Why? Because I was in a lack mindset. I come from nothing. I'm trying to become, I am something. I became something. And I'm in college doing the best I can. I see this woman, she flexing and flashing. I'm like, how do I get to that? Okay, licensures. Okay, she a boss. So, and this was my thinking, y'all. But it took for a parent who does not have licensures and degrees, because none of that stuff really means nothing. It's our soul, you guys. Our soul is what matters. I can't take my degrees with me when I go. But anyway, it took a parent who does not have all these credentials to see right through this woman. And here I am, my little student self, defending her like, no, she's a good person. This parent said, you are very condescending and I don't like you with my child. And here, and I'm just learning. I got to watch this. It's like eating popcorn. Like, oh, who's going to win this battle? That was the first incident. Then we had a kid who basically, she had me do it. I felt so uncomfortable. She wanted me to. And she even tried it. She got the mom to go through his tablet, all this stuff. She wanted me so bad to get this kid to admit that he was gay. And it's like, I felt so uncomfortable. I even talked about it to my class. Like, because this is why I love college. College to me was my family. Because I didn't have my own family, my peers who I graduated with, I will forever love y'all. But I came to class, and that's what we would do in class. We would go over what we learned at our internships. What is our supervisors teaching us? What are we learning with our clients? I brought this up because I thought I was wrong. But my class let me know that, no, my feelings was right. I told them exactly how it went, what happened, because it was a lot, y'all. I'm just piecing it together real quick. But they were like, no, it shouldn't matter if he's gay or not. What do it matter? He's a kid. He's not even a teenager yet, almost a teenager. He's a kid. Kids go through things. It's not our job to pick at them, are you gay? Are you gay? You're gay. Own your gayness. No, let them be a kid. If he's going to be gay, great. I'm still going to love you the same. You can come on and bring your gay behind right here, and I'm still going to love you, because that's just a title. That's a box. It don't make us who we are. On top of that, now let me tell y'all this. What the second supervisor did, they both got two things in common, right? My second supervisor is outside of college. Long story short, I took a position that was way beneath my pay rate, way beneath, but that's how humble I am. One of my clients, I had a lot, but one of them reminded me of one of my family members. So I'm like, I had a connection. I'm like, no, I'm going to stay. I'm going to help him. I'm going to give him my all. My supervisor saw that. She see it. She wasn't the supervisor. She was actually the owner of the company. She's and mind you, bragging about the degrees. They both did this. I have my doctorate. I have all these degrees. I know more than you. You are beneath me. So with that being said, the owner of this one company, she's like, I can replace you. Literally said this stuff to my face. She said, I can replace you. Nobody will hire you because you just graduated college. All this stuff. Know your place. You need to be humble. Be humble. I'm the most humblest person you will ever meet. I literally had to fucking crawl through dirt to get here. Like, don't tell me about humbleness. Do not. And this is the last thing I'm going to say to correlate these two so y'all can understand what an overt narc will do and why credentials don't matter and why it's your spirit. My spirit is so bright that these overt narcs wanted to hinder me. They both, now, like I told y'all, licensures matter, right? For this matrix. No, I'm not a licensed therapist yet. I could have had, there's so many type of licensures we can get. But this is how the matrix works. You go to school, you're in debt. Now they want you to pay all this money for licensures. It's just a whole another heap of bullshit. With that being said, there's so many as a therapist that I could get that one particular license that I could get was easy to get. And it was cheap. It was like $70. I'm like, oh yeah, that's easy. And mind you, this license will boost my pay rate by $7-$10, you know? But these overt narcs will know that. Okay, this young black girl graduated college. She damn good too. Damn, she doing a damn thing. Oh, she trying to get a license. Oh, she want money. No, I'm not gonna give you your hours. Literally, y'all, I got way over a thousand clinical hours with my clients, and all I needed was two signatures from both people. I needed two signatures from both people just to obtain this license that was so easy to get. Easy as shit. All you needed was the fucking hours. And they both, what they do, they literally both hindered me. They tried to hinder me. They couldn't hinder me, though, of course, because I'm God's child. This is why I'm letting y'all know my life is nothing but a testimony. You can keep your hours. I don't care. It ain't stopping me. You feel me? It ain't stopping nothing. You feel me? With that being said, y'all, these overt narcs will literally try to keep you small because they know that you are really big. Yeah, I'm still a therapist. So the difference between... the difference between being a therapist and this matrix, having a license and not having a license, is just the pay. That's really it. Me being a therapist versus someone else who's licensed, they're just getting more money by the books because they have that license. But that license also is very expensive and very tedious to get. And like I said, they know this. These overt narcs who have been in the mental health field for 20 plus years know how it goes to climb up a ladder, know how it goes to possibly be single and getting out of college, just trying to plant your feet in the ground. Damn, can I plant my feet in the ground? Can I get established? Can I get some moolah? But this is what they do. They try to punish you. My internship narc, the reason why she tried to punish me was because, and mind y'all, that's why I'm Princey 215. I am from Philly, but I don't live in Philly, and I don't want to live in Philly. The fuck? She would tell me, she wanted me to accept a job from her that was in Philly, and I said, no, I'm cool. When I graduate, I'm going somewhere else. I'm not coming back here. So she was like, you're running from your problems. And this is why I told y'all she wasn't from America. All this matters, y'all. This narcissistic woman who is not from America is going to tell an American woman what she's running from? Did you live in Philly for fucking 20 plus years of your life straight? I lived in Philly for 22 years of my life straight. I moved out of Philly when I was 22 to attend college. And I stayed 5 years, did damn good. That's why I told y'all, in the Promise program, I stayed in the homeless program. And when people would leave for breaks, when people leave to go home for Christmas and all that, I'm in my dorm taking classes, taking notes. I'm learning, I'm feeding my brain, because growing up, I didn't have an education. So I had to basically rewire myself. I reparented myself along the journey. My 5 years in college was me reparenting myself, me re-educating myself, and me reprogramming my subconscious mind. That's what I did. I get that credit. I created this avatar. God and Gaia and my spirit team is with me. So this woman does not know me at all, but will say, you are running from Philly, because I don't want to accept her job. Because she, and this is how God worked, y'all. This is why I'm telling y'all. I'm so proud of my decisions. Even though I didn't accept her job and I wound up getting a job that was underpaid, and I was working with for another narcissistic woman. But the reason, but this is how God worked. My client who was there, I don't care. The money, I don't care that I was underpaid. I don't care that I worked for a narcissistic company, because I touched my client's heart. I had a lot. I know I touched all their hearts, but it was one particular client who reminded me of my brothers, who I felt like, you know what? I'm gonna do my best with him. And I did. I gave him my all. And that same woman who also would not give me my hours too for her company, this is why I'm telling y'all, for me to obtain a license, just for me to get a $7 increase, $7, $10 increase, they don't wanna give me my hours because of how great I am. I did everything by the books. I did my leave of absence way ahead of time. Just how this woman said, are you sure you wanna leave here? I offer so many benefits. What benefits are you offering me? I'm literally underpaid and I'm only here because of one client. And she knew that. And she said, oh, well, don't you want to stay with him? So by her telling me, are you sure that you don't want to stay here because nobody will hire you? Guess what? I'm living my best life, love. I left there. Now, mind y'all, this is all about 3 months ago. 3 months ago, I had enough. I said, I got to leave these narcs. And I'm living my best life. So don't listen to nobody, y'all. These narcs, these overt narcs really want to have control over your ascension. They want to have control over when you rise. But love, you cannot control when I rise, because God and Gaia are in say-so of everything. God and Gaia govern this whole planet. You do not have powers that are bigger than God and Gaia. So I know this video was long, but I really wanted to give you a really deep explanation and to see how overt narcs are. They will be so happy when you are on their team because they're controlling you. I am a representation of this. I am a light worker. My heart is pure. Anybody who has me in their company is only going to succeed even more because of the service and the quality care that I give my clients. So even though I'm in this matrix, this is what you have to understand, you guys. We are in the matrix, but there's thousands of jobs out here, okay? Thousands. You have to listen to your heart. You have to listen to your heart. And if you're going to work for a matrix job, why not work somewhere that's going to respect you? I don't got to work for somebody who's going to demean me, who's going to make me feel small, who's going to not pay me my worth when this government is already taking all our money anyway. I'm working. This money ain't mine. I'm very aware that this money is not mine. I know what's going on. I'm woke. So you're not about to use me. I'm not about to work for you and be underpaid when this government is going to take a big chunk of my money every paycheck. So you're just disrespecting me at that point. Why not go somewhere else that's going to double the pay? Because it's about, that's another thing I'm going to tell y'all, it's really about your hourly. Yeah, hourly is really what matters. The more you can get an hour, and don't get me wrong, they're still going to take your taxes, but it'll even itself out. When you can get more hourly, then you will still see a bigger check than versus when you have less hourly and you work so many hours. All right, I'm going to give an example. Let's say if you work 10 hours, right, and you're getting paid $15 an hour, and then that 10 an hour, $15 an hour, when they take your money out your check, they're going to take a good $50 out your check, right? But if you was getting paid $20 an hour, 10 hours a week, and they come around and they take money out your check, they might take a good, because of the hour, again, the 10 hours versus hourly. Now they're going to take a good $60 out your check. You get what I'm saying? So now that you got $20 an hour, you still have a little more, even though they're still taking money, but you'll be able to see something and maneuver. You'll be able to be a magician with that a little bit more just because of the hourly pay. The hourly pay is really how you try. You can't, it's hard to really beat this matrix just because is a fucking system. So instead of going against it, and I hate this matrix, because that's how I went through that, y'all. I was on some shit. I'm like, yo, I got my degrees, I'm in debt, what the fuck, why is y'all acting weird, bro? Why you being weird? But now I get it, y'all. I get it. I'm not fighting this. My spirit team fight stuff for me. I'm all I gotta do is show up with my heart on my sleeve, because I wear my heart on my sleeve, baby. I love all my clients. That's all I gotta do. this matrix, whatever company you work for as a light worker, you don't work for them. You work for God and Gaia. None of these companies own me. I am owned by God and Gaia. You are a third party for me to be able to spread love through another person. You're just, these companies are third parties. That's how y'all gotta look at it. We're in a matrix. Whatever company you work for is only a third party for you to touch the hearts of other kings and queens. We are owned by God and Gaia, and that's what these companies will tell you. My last company that I worked for that was narcissistic told me that when I'm in this world, I represent her. No, I don't. I represent God and Gaia. I'm a spiritual being. I'm eternal, okay? I got royal blood in my veins. I have God genes in me. I am a fucking God. I don't represent you. You didn't walk in my path. I've been in this world for 20 plus years, baby. I just, come on. Y'all be sounding dumb. How y'all take somebody who got a whole life experience to a 20-year-old? You represent me when you're out here. That 20-year-old represents the 20 years that they had to walk this fucking earth, all their experiences, all their childhood traumas, their child development. Even if it wasn't no trauma, I am a trauma-informed therapist, so I like trauma. But even if it wasn't trauma, how you gonna say they represent you? They represent their parents. If they had good, healthy parents, good, healthy environment, they are a representation of what they come from. I am not a representation of you. I don't even fucking know you. What the fuck? Are you fucking dumb? Anyway, y'all, 30 minutes. I love y'all. I bet you this 30 minutes really helped change your life. If you really stayed to the end, please drop a comment. Just put a heart if you stayed to the end, because I'm really trying to spread my word and really help y'all, okay? Peace, love, and light to you. Deuces.